So good morning, I'm Samir. I'm a sales manager in the for the UK and Irish markets for Twitter in Dublin. So flown over for the event this morning. And today I'm going to talk to you about marketing in the moment. So before I get into that, I'm going to speak to you a little bit about Twitter and some stats around the platform and some updated stats, and then we'll get into how we can think about planning for the moment, marketing in the moment, and how you can handle that. So Twitter is really the live medium. We're tweeting about digital journeys as it happens right now because it is the platform where people go to talk about what's happening in the real world. What happens in the real world happens on Twitter. There are 255 million monthly active users. So there's this scale on the platform. And you'll see a bit later, 80% of those users are actually on their mobile devices. Twitter was born mobile, started as an SMS service, and continues to show that kind of mobile behavior. In the UK specifically, there are 15 million active users. So there is quite a bit of scale. And more importantly, across the globe, there are 500 million tweets every single day, 1 billion tweets every 2 days, that are actually moments for you to engage with in terms of your marketing plans. And I'll talk through some of that now. So we've got a platform that's live, it's conversational, it's public, it's got scale, and there's a lot happening on it. As I mentioned, 80% use a mobile device to access Twitter. People are on the go, people are sitting in the audience tweeting about what's happening. So mobile is really key to Twitter. Now, as I mentioned, what happens in the real world happens on Twitter. I was watching the USA-Belgium match last night. After the Belgians scored, literally 4 seconds after I saw it on the screen, there was a tweet about it on Twitter. It just happened instantaneously, and I found it staggering. An example of what this looks like. So this is obviously from a few weeks back. I'm going to show you a visualization of the tweets that are occurring around the world during the England-Uruguay match. And what I want you to take a look at is, at the bottom, you'll see the timeline moving, and you'll also see some key moments called out, which is essentially the goals. And you'll see on the actual globe, the map of the world there, you'll see the flashes in blue are tweets about Uruguay. The flashes in red are tweets about England. And you'll see how the tweet bubbles kind of react to the different events in the match. So we'll just run through. So kind of steady conversation happening during the game, talking about what's happening in the game. And then as soon as you see a goal, this is Luis Suarez, you see the explosion of tweets. So what's happening in the game is happening on Twitter. And shortly you'll see the English equalizer from Wayne Rooney. There you go. And then Suarez ending the game 2-1. So very clear, that's the end of the match, as you see it's exploding as well. So what happens in the real world happens on Twitter. And we've got tons of examples around that, the Champions League final, the World Cup from a few years ago, and I'll show you a couple more going on. So one of the interesting things, again, we know what happened in the Uruguay-Italy match where Suarez fell on the Italian defender and left his teeth imprints on his shoulder somehow. And brands took advantage of this moment. So immediately, Bud Light comes out, relax, their twist off in reference to Suarez biting. As you can see, the hashtag biting in the tweet. Nando's, great account. You should take a look at it. Hey, Luis Suarez, if you're that hungry, why not get your teeth stuck into something really tasty with a picture of their chicken? And then Snickers, more satisfying than Italian. Just great advantage, taking advantage of what's just happened in the match. People are talking about it. And I got home that day, opened my Twitter feed, and it was just full of stuff like this, which was just incredible. But what's more important than this is stuff that's happening on the platform. But what people maybe fail to understand is this has reached beyond Twitter as a platform. So if we look at what's happening off platform, now this is Yahoo Sports showing a picture of the tweet. Marketing Land has an article about the brands that take advantage of this moment. Same with Marketing Week, talking about the Nando's ad. the drum talking about how the brands reacted on Twitter, and the same with the Independent, so into kind of mainstream media. So the reach of what's happened on Twitter is not just to the followers of that account or people on Twitter, it's gone into mainstream media. And that reach is something that people often underestimate. Now, how do we take advantage of that? How do we think about what's happening in the real world, happening on Twitter, and how do we then, as marketeers, to decide to take advantage of that? Now, this slide, I'm going to spend a little bit of time on it. If there's one thing you take away from my presentation today, it's this slide. What this is, let me take you through it. So this is how we at Twitter think about marketing in the moment. So we've got a matrix here, which essentially goes from on the x-axis, always on, to events. So always on being things that happen every day, moments that happen every day, and I'll take you through some examples of that, to tentpole events, such as the World Cup, Glastonbury that's just happened, the Oscars, the Super Bowl, that kind of stuff. And then on the y-axis, on the vertical axis, from planned to unplanned. So there are things that are happening every day that are planned, you can plan for them, as well as events. You know the World Cup is coming up, you can plan around that event, as well as unplanned. Nobody knew, probably not even Suarez himself, that he was going to bite the Italian defender, but that's something that did happen and that brands can react to. So I'm going to go through the different quadrants and show you examples of what this means. And we'll start with every day. So every day. So these are moments that are happening every day all around us, things that we can actually plan for. We're in beautiful weather today. It's 3 months of summer ahead, hopefully of this exact same weather. And there are things that are happening, whether people are on holiday or still at home, that you can actually plan for and react to. People share summer moments every day on Twitter. And I'm going to take you to three examples of summer moments on Twitter and how brands have taken advantage of some of those. So starting with holidays. Now, if you're like me, you would have assumed before seeing this that people put their phones down when they go on holidays. And in fact, our researchers found that 2/3 of Twitter users actually are still using Twitter while on holiday. And 71% of them are actually tweeting about their holiday while they're on holiday. So it's not necessary that they're actually putting their phones on it and switching off entirely from this kind of media. What are they doing on Twitter? So there's a couple of stats there. I'm going to call out two of them. 1 in 2 use Twitter to stay in touch with news. And almost 60% use it to stay in touch with people they know. Now, I was recently on holiday in Santorini in Greece, and for some reason, I found myself using Twitter more than I normally would, even though I work with it every day. And really, all I was doing was I wanted to keep in touch with news. The World Cup had just started, and with people I knew. And I was craving this kind of engagement that I wanted to have with what is happening in the world around me and what people back home were doing. So how can you take advantage of those holiday moments? Now, in the UK, every week, there are 310,000 mentions of holiday and travel-related terms on Twitter every single week. And those are actually 310,000 moments that you have to engage with your consumer, your target market. This is a very, very simple, innocuous example of just how a brand is switched on to what's happening and is taking advantage of it. So Simon Heaton here tweeting about, while in Croatia, hashtag holidays, try these traditional sweets from Dubrovnik at Thomson Holidays. Now, he's tagged Thomson Holidays. And so if they're listening, it's him inviting them to kind of engage with him. And they were listening. They look nice, Simon. What flavor are they? And he responds, sugared orange peel is the one I'm eating in the picture. Never knew orange peel could taste so nice. Now, it's a very simple, straightforward example. It happens every day on Twitter, but that's the point. This is a brand that knows people are on holiday, people are tweeting about the holiday, and he's actually invited them to have a discussion with him. Now, arguably, that strengthens the connection between the brand and the consumer. So that's something that you can do. There's no promotion here. It's just organic activity, people getting themselves set up, planning for the holiday moments that they know are going to happen. One more holiday example. I put this up. It is a promoted tweet, but what happened here was I was actually searching on Twitter for holiday before I chose to go to Santorini, looking for pictures of places and so on. And I was immediately served this ad by Virgin Atlantic. They had set themselves up because they knew people would be searching for the term holiday on Twitter, and they got themselves ready advertising a competition about winning a trip to New York City. And it was just so timely and relevant. I was like, I have to take a screenshot of this. But a great example of a brand knowing that these moments are happening and planning for it. So the next everyday summer moment, it's summer, there's summer sales, people are shopping, people are out and about. And what you see here is the tweet volume by day, on average across the summer months last year. And what you see is a very interesting trend. Friday evening, Friday afternoon, people are tweeting about shopping. And then Saturday morning, you see people are also tweeting about shopping quite a bit more than the rest of the week. That's when that activity is happening. It's 120,000 mentions of shopping-related terms on Twitter every single week. And that's something you can take advantage of. I'll show you two quick examples from brands that know this is happening and have really just geared themselves up to take advantage of this. So JD Sports, great account, take a look at it. They've got great organic content. Heading off on your travels this summer, check out our large selection of men's flip-flops. I could have used that before going to Santorini, but that's just a great example of them linking the moment of summer and shopping because they know people are looking for this kind of apparel. And one more from Marks & Spencer. Is there such a thing as too many necklaces? If you need an excuse, these ones are on sale. So they link the fact that people are looking for new summer wardrobes, looking to accessorize the summer wardrobes, and just put out a very kind of visually engaging tweet about it, linking summer and the sales. And one final summer moment is the social moments. So the tweet volume around pubs in the UK, you can see the massive spike on Friday afternoon, evening, and then again Saturday afternoon, which kind of mirrors the behavior we see in real life. 120,000 mentions of the word pub per week in the UK, unsurprisingly. And this is with weather like this, you can be sure the pubs are going to be full. You can take advantage of these moments to engage. Bacardi UK, doing a great tweet, the perfect serve for summer and a no ordinary juice cocktail. They've combined summer, combined sports, and we'll talk about sports in a bit, and just put out a nice visually engaging tweet that takes advantage of the moment. So that's every day. That's stuff that's happening all the time. You can plan for it, they're predictable, and you can get ahead of those things. Moving on to campaign. Now, campaigns are something you can maybe plan a bit further ahead for. They're probably an integrated marketing campaign. You can use multiple forms of media. And I'm going to take you through one example, Tommy Hilfiger. Now, Tommy Hilfiger was trying to promote or trying to drive awareness of the new summer collection called Surf Shack. Kind of, they call it après surf lifestyle clothing. And so they drove an integrated marketing campaign using print, PR, and they decided to accelerate that using Twitter and Instagram. And so they asked their consumers to basically tweet pictures of their favorite surfing spots or surfing tips with the hashtag Gone Surfing. And some of that's just the creative around the campaign. On the right image, you see some of the pictures that their consumers have sent in. Now, what they've done is an interesting thing here. So they've tweeted out from their account, Tommy Hilfiger on the left, want to win a trip for two to paradise, share photos and tips about your summer hotspot, tag with hashtag Gone Surfing across Europe. And then they realize, well, we've actually got influencer accounts also on Twitter that have kind of followers that are also our target market. And so they got in touch with Glamour Paris, as well as GQ Spain and Elle Netherlands, and got them to tweet out about the competition and with the hashtag Gone Surfing. You'll see in those tweets. They also used a Twitter function called whitelisting, where they're with the permission of those accounts, are able to promote those tweets directly from those accounts. So they've got kind of social proof around the other brands building up around this campaign. And the results are just staggering. 56.5 million impressions, 8.6% engagement rate at peak. Now they planned this, planned ahead, got everything in line, and executed really, really well. It's actually a case study on the Twitter website. You can go take a look in more detail. So that's campaign. Now talk about Reactive. Reactive's, you know, on Twitter, it's the one that gets the most attention because somebody, you know, is really smart in the moment and reacts to something that's just happened, and it gets a lot of kind of viral media. I'm going to take you through one, a little bit of a simple example, which could have been a PR disaster, but turned into quite a nice moment in the end. So for Reactive, you actually need to be prepared for the unexpected. You don't know what's going to happen. This is unplanned. You don't know what's going to happen in the real world or even on Twitter or with your account. You need to be prepared for that. So Heidi, I think it's Hatfield, tweets at Kellogg's UK, look what I just found in my crunchy nut cornflakes. You could have left me a whole one. If you can't see what that is, it's a sweet wrapper that she found in her box of cereal. Shouldn't have been there. Potential PR disaster. It's now public, it's on Twitter, and can go viral very, very quickly. So Kellogg's UK is prepared for this. They've got an account that is listening out for these tweets. She's tagged them, thankfully, in that, so they can pick it up a bit more easily. And they've said, look, just spotted a tweet, direct message us so we can deal with this appropriately. Trying to take it off take the conversation off the public eye. And Heidi then tweets back. She's actually not that fussed. It's okay, I'm not traumatized by it. You haven't lost my custom. I was more amused than anything. Thanks for responding. So they said, okay, great. If you're okay with that, that's fine. But Heidi then decides to have a little bit of fun with it. Thinking about it, though, you could send Tony the Tiger around to have breakfast with me. Tony the Tiger shows up for breakfast. So that's a potential PR nightmare that Kellogg's, just by listening, and it's two tweets, and Tony the Tiger, just save the moment and arguably strengthen the connection between the consumer and the brand. Really nice example. There's thousands and thousands of these on the platform every day. And then finally, my favorite part of the presentation is live. Now, live are those tentpole events that happen. We're in one right now. We're in a summer of sports. We've got Wimbledon. We've got Tour de France. We've got obviously the World Cup. A whole bunch of stuff happening that you can take advantage of. But just remember that live doesn't necessarily mean sports. As I mentioned before, we've had Glastonbury, which just happened. A lot of tweets about Glastonbury. There's wireless coming up, there's Electric Daisy, there's movie releases, there's theatrical releases, there's political events that are happening. There's live events happening all the time that you know are coming that you can plan around. I am going to take us through some sports because sports is quite apt right now. We've got a lot of sports on the go. And really, sport does thrive on Twitter. The average sports user is more active on the platform than the average Twitter user. And you can see that through the stats. Wimbledon last year, 5.7 million tweets during the tournament. The Champions League final over that 90 minutes, 8.4 million tweets. That was a 75% increase on the previous year. The Sochi Olympics during the games, 40 million tweets during those 2 weeks. And the World Cup, now this stat is, I think it's 8 days old. We've released a blog a couple days ago that said we've actually got 300 million tweets around the World Cup so far. And last night there were another 15, 16 million tweets over the two games. So there's a lot of activity around sports on the platform, moments that you are able to kind of take advantage of and engage with. Now, there's a little lawn tennis club that holds a competition every year that's on right now. And I want you to cast your minds back to last year when Andy Murray won Wimbledon. And let's just take a look at that moment.
Quiet, please. Play.
Second match, Murray. This is still out.
Can't believe it.
6-4, 7-5, 6-4.
So clearly a lot of emotion there, and it had been a long slog for him. This is the volume of tweets during that final, just during that match, 3.2 million tweets. And that spike is exactly when Novak Djokovic hit the ball into the net, exactly when Andy Murray won the whole tournament. So again, what happens in the real world happens on Twitter. And we have some, we call them VITs, very important tweeters. Victoria Beckham, very nice seat, obviously, at center court, taking a picture of Andy Murray holding the trophy. Congratulations to Andy Murray and his family. Wonderful day at Wimbledon. So proud to be British. Andy Murray himself, in disbelief, can't believe what just happened. And one of my favorite things about Twitter is the kind of conversations that you now are able to kind of witness on the platform. Andy Roddick, a US tennis player. Matches like today are why Andy Murray's become a champion. Far less than his best half today was able to advance, fight another day. And Andy Murray responding, thanks mate, hope you're well. Just a casual conversation, but now we are able to kind of take a look at that and be privy to it as well. So there's people tweeting about it, people that are celebrities that have a lot of followers, but this wasn't just a moment for them, it was a key moment for brands as well. Now, Wimbledon is happening. You know it's happening. You know what's happening day to day. You know what the final's going to be before it starts. And so Adidas UK, one of the really great accounts that take advantage of the moment, they had obviously planned this. After the hurt, pain, and tears, he came back stronger, faster, better. With a little word in the image, Wimbledon, he's finally done it. But what they've done is they've recognized the journey he had come through. A lot of struggle to get to where he did. And they had planned that, and they kind of captured the moment around it. Again, congratulations, Andy Murray. Not bad for a man with no personality. That was based on a tweet he had himself sent out about winning Wimbledon. So again, taking advantage of the moment, they know it could have been Djokovic winning, it could have been Murray, but when Murray did win, they were ready for it. And they tweeted out about it. There will be a lot of high interest live moments coming up. We've got Wimbledon on now, Tour de France, Silverstone this weekend. The World Cup final obviously is going to be huge. Commonwealth Games, Community Shield, the Premier League starts again, US Open, Ryder Cup. These are just a select few of the events, sporting events happening over the next few months. You should start thinking about what else is relevant to my brand to get involved in that I can start planning for now. Now, before I wrap up, the idea that Twitter and all, you know, Facebook and all the kind of social elements totally upend what you've been doing in marketing, we don't look at it that way. The old rules of marketing still apply. So you're looking for the right message for the right audience. And the crucial dimension that Twitter brings is timing. So you're looking for the right message for the right audience at the right moment. And so I encourage you to start thinking about what are the moments that you need to start planning for. That's it. Thank you.